two male nuclei are formed. Is it clear? You can call them as male gametes also. And this is the tube nucleus. This is tube nucleus. Is it clear? And it keeps elongating. All right, it keeps elongating until it reaches into the ovary. So this goes the male part. If we are telling you about the pollen grain, that is the male part. That is, now we come to the female part. Is it all right? So here it is. What is a female part like? A female part has a stigma. Stigma varies. It can be disc-like, it can be round, isn't clear, bulb-like, whatever, that it varies. This is the style, and this goes as the ovary. Let us not make a very big style, and this goes as the ovary. Inside the ovary is present the ovule. Is it clear? So let us see what is ovule like. There is a stalk by which the ovule is attached. The number of ovules vary. It can be one to numerous. And how do you know it's one if the fruit has only one seed? Number of ovules are one. Is it all right? Because ovules finally forms the seed. The ovules vary from, means it, like in in mango you have seen only one, so there is only one ovule. Ovary has only one ovule. Tomato you have seen numerous. Chilies you have seen numerous. Is it clear? Pea you have seen numerous. So they are many, means numerous ovules. All right, so here this is the ovule. Is it all right? So let us see what is an ovule like. All right, this is the ovary, and this is what I'm drawing right now is an ovule. The ovule is composed of, you have done in class 8 as well, if you remember, is it? So the ovule is composed of two integuments. Usually it is composed of two integuments. Two integuments, all right? Okay, this is the integument, all right? Inside it, there is a large nucellus. I'll just use the terms and I'll label it later on, all right? And inside the nucellus, there is present an embryo sac. Nucellus term is there in your book, so I'm using, all right? So here, let us first finish drawing it and then I'll label them. This opening is known as micropyle. Even after fertilization, this remains. Is it clear? This is called micropyle. Now, towards this end, there are present two large cells. Is it all right? So these cells are known as the synergids. And in between the synergids, there is present an egg cell. All right, how many cells we can see here? Inside the embryo sac, we can see three cells, two synergids and one egg cell. In the center, there is present a central cell with two nuclei. All right, okay. So these two nuclei are called polar nuclei. All right, what have we used the term? Generative nuclei. And here are two polar nuclei. And on top, opposite to synergids, there are present T3 nutritive cells. Is it clear? They are known as the antipodal cells. So how many cells we have drawn? This is the embryo sac. This is the embryo sac. Is it all right? And inside the embryo sac, how many cells we are finding? 1, 2, 3, 3 antipodal cells, 1 central cell, and 3, 2 synergids, 1 egg cell. Is it all right? So how many are there total? There are 7 cells. Is it clear? Out of which one cell contains 2 nuclei. Now just let us label them. This is the stigma. This is style. This is ovary. Ovary, is it? This part is consisting of nutritive cells, is it clear? And this is known as the nucellus. Okay, protective nutritive soft mass of cell. This is known as the outer integument. This is the outer integument. Is it all right? And this is called the inner integument. Okay, the cells I'll be labeling this side. Okay, and this opening is known as micropyle. All these terms are there in your book, so I am mentioning. There are more structures we will not label since it is not there in your syllabus. Okay, so this is micropyle. All right, this talk is called funicle, not there, so I'm not mentioning. Now let us label the cells. What is there? These are antipodal cells. Antipodal cells. Okay, these are nutritive. After fertilization, they provide nutrition to the endosperm. We will come to it. What is, how many are there? They are 3 in number. Is it clear? There is a central cell containing 2 nuclei. It is 1 in number. Is it clear? Containing 2 polar nuclei. These are the polar nuclei. Is it? Containing 2 polar nuclei. All right. These are the synergids. These are synergids. How many are they? Synergids. How many are they? They are 2 in number. And this is what? This is the female cell or the egg cell. Is it clear how many it is? How many are they? They are 1 in number. Is it all right? So there is 1 synergid. Is it all right? Now, sorry, there is 1 egg cell. So just let us do little bit with fertilization. We have seen that how this pollen tube is growing, isn't it? The pollen tube is growing. So here is now, this is what, repeating, this is the outer integument, inner integument. Here is, this whole structure is the ovule. This whole structure is ovule. This structure is ovule. Whole structure. In ovule is present the nucellus, the embryo sac. Embryo sac containing 3, here, let me explain, write it. This is the embryo sac. This is embryo sac. This one is embryo sac. This one is embryo sac. This is embryo sac. Is it all right? This one is embryo sac. Is it okay? And there is present outside and inside the embryo sac, there are 3 antipodal cells, there is 1 central cell, there are 2 synergids and 1 egg cell. Now you see what we have seen, that germination is taking place, the pollen tube is germinating and the pollen tube grows like this. Is it clear how it is germinating? I have already explained. Alright, the pollen tube grows like this. I am just rubbing off the, you have already seen, you can, so it is like this. Alright, it goes like this. The pollen tube elongates. Elongation of pollen tube. Pollen tube elongates. So here what we see, here is the pollen, this is the tube nuclei, this is the tube nuclei, this is the first male nuclei and tube nucleus, the first male nucleus and second male nucleus. When do we use the term nuclei? The plural of nucleus is nuclei. This is the first please refer to this diagram. This is the tube nucleus, is it all right? This is the first male nucleus and this is the second male nucleus, is it clear? And now it enters through the micropyle. Usually it enters through the micropyle. There are exceptions also. It enters through the micropyle. All right, okay. It enters through the micropyle into one of the synergids. Here is the tube nuclei, first male nucleus, second male nucleus. Tube nucleus, first male nucleus, second male nucleus. So it enters into one of the synergids. It doesn't enter into the egg cell directly. And then through the synergids, is it clear? Through the synergids, now what happens? The tube nucleus, this cell degenerates and now this moves out. All right. The first male nucleus fuses with the egg cell. How many male nuclei are there? There are two. The first male nucleus fuses with the egg nucleus. Is it all right? Egg cell containing, this is egg cell containing egg nucleus. It contains egg nucleus. A cell contains nucleus, is it clear? So this fusion takes place. And after the fusion, what is formed? Is formed the zygote. The zygote is the single cell structure which will give rise to the baby plant. Is it all right? Now the first male nucleus, the first male nucleus has fused with the egg cell. What about the second male nucleus? There is one more male nucleus. It goes further, is it clear? And fuses with the two polar nuclei. How many polar nucleus are there? How many polar nuclei are there? There are two. So the second male nucleus fuses with the two polar nuclei. Where are the two polar nuclei present? Polar nuclei. Where are the two polar nuclei present? They are present inside the central cell. Is it all right? And here, after the fusion, it forms the endosperm. We will discuss about the function of endosperm later on. So how many fusions are taking place? Twice.